Hey everybody, Chris Pearson here with another episode of NebuloCity. Thanks so much for joining. So what do you do when an object you're trying to photograph is just setting earlier and earlier in the night sky? Do you give up? Well, that's what this video is all about. So if you've ever sort of wondered what can you do, what's possible with that late set object, hopefully this video illuminates a little bit of what the possibilities are in that arena. The object I'm looking at in this particular video is the Cone Nebula and the Christmas tree cluster more broadly. That's NGC 2264, located in the constellation Monoceros. It's about 2600 light years away, a very rich hydrogen gas nebula peppered with a lot of stars. So the goal is to take my one-shot color camera, which I gotta be honest, really shines in this particular moment, where you gotta get the rig out there in short order, get things set up, get polar aligned, and start taking images as soon as it gets dark. In this case, it's the ZWO ASI2600MC-Pro. I'm also gonna be using the Optolong L-Extreme filter to isolate the hydrogen gas as well as oxygen, all of it mounted on my HEQ5 Pro. And what I'm gonna hopefully do is set that rig up day after day on site, try to capture sort of between the 7:30 to 11:30 p.m. hour timeframe as many frames as I can. Use Deep Sky Stacker, a wonderful program that helps you to integrate files over multiple nights. I'm still using Photoshop and Lightroom for my post-process editing. Hopefully one day I'll graduate to sort of, you know, PixInsight and be able to sort of master some of the functions in that software. But for now, Deep Sky Stacker, Adobe Photoshop, and Lightroom is where I'm at. So again, that's the overall premise here. I'm hoping I can capture somewhere between, I don't know, 10, maybe 15 hours of total integration time, which would be massive. And to see, can we still squeeze out enough data through these last nights in March to capture what is ostensibly a winter object? That's what this video is all about. Hopefully you enjoy it. If you do, feel free to hit the like button below, leave a comment, subscribe to this channel. I just love sharing this content with you guys and being able to show you what's working, what's not working, and answering any questions you have about this wonderful hobby. So thanks so much, and as always, let's get to it.
Spaceships from far away, we're already here on the Earth today. Just so small that you wouldn't believe, travel at speeds that we couldn't conceive. That means one could slip right by, undetected to the human eye. Try to catch one, you wouldn't stand a chance, because they're just so small yet so advanced. Oh, tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we'd never notice. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we'd never notice. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. Tiny spaceships the size of gnats end up getting eaten by hungry bats, or snatched up by a frog's long tongue. The tiny spaceman would be long gone. Lost on a mission is one of the few to study the giants of planet blue. That's me and you. You wanna know why? 'Cause we are the aliens in their eyes. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. We're up there from a planet that's cold and gray, in a universe light years away. And even though it sounds like it's very far.
Okay guys, day 3 of 5. I'm gonna be real quick. Just past midnight here, I'm shooting 5-minute subs. I've got a couple of hundred of them at this point. We just passed a big milestone, 10 hours of total integration time, and I've got two more nights of clear skies forecasted. Knock on wood, that does not change. I was shooting 4 minutes earlier, but the histogram, I just didn't like what I was seeing. Not enough light hitting the sensor at 4 minutes, in part because I'm using the Optolong L-Extreme narrowband filter. I was also shooting 6 minute subs, but the stars were more bloated and elongated, in part because my tracking was so bad. It's sort of between 1 and 1.3 seconds of error. But you know, don't fret on the tracking. You know, for wide field astrophotography, you're gonna get some forgiveness. And at 5 minutes, even at 1 second of error, the stars in the middle are really pinpoint. You don't really notice anything until you get to the exterior of the image. So don't freak out. I produced a lot of images around 1 second of error, and I'm gonna do it again here on this one. Hopefully we can get around 15 hours of total data and see what comes of it. At the same time, I've got the Dobsonian out there. I'm looking at the night sky. I'm looking at those objects, taking it all in. So let's get back to it, and we'll see at the end of the video, you know, what we're able to produce. Being able to shoot the night sky is such a privilege. I can't even begin to describe the profound sense of humility I feel each and every night when I take my gear out and I point it towards the sky.